On this video, I'm going to answer your question, what do I leave in my camper when we're not in use? So I was starting to get everything ready for our trip and bringing stuff out here, and then I got to thinking, you would probably like to know what we keep in our camper that I never take out. Our camper is not stored at a place. It is kept at our house and in our driveway. And two, if you notice that looking out the windows, we're looking at a different view. Well, that's because we are getting a new driveway put in, and they're actually had a designated pad for the camper. So it's gonna have a new home back there, and we're gonna work on getting a cover for it. And I think I'm gonna record that process because I've kind of started and more difficult than I thought it would be. So I may take you along with that process. If y'all want me to record all that, let me know in the description box if that would be something you were interested in on the cover for our camper. Because our camper is stored at the house, I feel like maybe things would be different. We never have to winterize our camper either, because during the winter months when it is cold, we keep it at the hunting club and we live in it 5 days typically of the week. We will drain the water and we kind of do a little bit. I'll leave the heat on so that it'll stay around 40 so it doesn't get freezing cold inside the camper. And that's just what we do for the winter time. But when we are not camping, the lot of things that we take out of the camper is the first thing that you do. You do not want to leave any, I say any, food of any sort in your camper. The rats, the mice, even if you don't have a problem, you will have a problem. We don't keep any kind of food at all in our camper, and we got mice this year for the first time. We live out in the country, and the guy next to us has a big field, and when he cut it, I guess they came in somehow, and they ate my oven mitt. That's how I knew that I had them. Didn't see a lot of droppings or anything. I don't know if he left because there wasn't anything here, but we haven't had any problems. I put out some traps and we got nothing, and I haven't seen any more except for the oven mitt being eaten. Hopefully he vacated the property since there was nothing here for him. Now, I do keep in my camper, I leave all my pots and my pans in here. All my plates, my cups, all that stays in. I do have what I call camper clothes, and I keep clothes in here that are my camper clothes. They're clothes that I love, that maybe, you know, got a little stain on them or got a hole in them. They're just not like my something I'm gonna wear all the time. So I keep those in my camper. I keep my bed already made. Typically, when we get back from a trip, I strip the bed, I wash everything, and put it back on there so that when we go on the next trip, it is already ready for us. I don't have to rewash it. I don't have a problem with it starting to smell or anything happening, because we haven't traveled in the camper in probably 3 months, and the bedding is all fresh and still ready for me to go. That's why it's less headache on me the week that we leave. I know that the sheets, towels, all that is done. I do leave towels in here. That all stays in here. I have camper makeup. I typically, when we go on vacation, I just do my eyebrows, some mascara, eyeliner. I leave that in the camper all the time. I don't ever take it out. I do leave like shampoo, conditioner, soap, just all your basic stuff. That all stays in the camper as well. Now, Vail, she gets to keep some toys in here, and we keep toys in here so that way when she comes to the camper, that makes her feel like home. And if you haven't watched the video of traveling with dogs, I'll link that up above. That kind of gives you some tips and tricks on taking your dogs with you camping. Now, under the camper, we keep our tables, our outside tables, our outside chairs. I have some games and stuff, and all that we leave in here all the time. Now, if you haven't watched it, I do have a video on what we do prepare to leave, and I will link that so that that way you can watch that so you can see how we prepare. I did leave this oil in here because I thought, oh, it won't hurt nothing. A few times during the winter, it froze soft, not froze, but it got like done. So I'm gonna probably end up throwing it away because I wasn't thinking about it when I left it in here. I thought, oh, well, the rats are not gonna want that. But if you notice everything else, I don't have anything in our camper at all. I make sure all our food and everything is in the house and not in the camper because we don't want to get mice to come in here. I already brought some of this out here, but I keep my flour, sugar, cornmeal, Bisquick, all that. I keep them in these containers that I had gotten at the Dollar Tree. And then I just take them in the house when we're not going to use them, and then I bring them back out here and put them in here when we're getting ready to travel again. I guess I'm fortunate enough, I have a big size pantry and I have like a little section in my pantry that I keep all the RV stuff at. And it's the same way my spices, I have all these in these I got these at the Dollar Tree, and I keep like extra pepper, taco sauce, season, and I just have a bunch of seasonings in here. And then I have some of them in these as well. And I just take them at the end of our trip. I load all this into one basket. But yeah, I keep all my plates, cups. I don't take those in and out. As well as my, I have pots in here. And these here are from the Dollar Tree. They're pot liners and they just keep everything from rattling, and they help a lot. Here in the bathroom, I keep deodorant in here, some of my hair care products, deodorant. We just leave that in here, as well as our shampoo. If you like the way the bathroom looks, I do have a video on that as well to talk to you about how I organized my bathroom. Now, I do have towels that I keep in here all the time, but like this trip that was coming up, we're gonna be gone a week, and I'll probably go through way more towels than I have. So I have storage behind this for more towels, not my pretty towels. I keep my pretty towels here. I keep all our first aid and a lot of that. I don't take it out, it stays in here as well. So it wasn't nothing crazy when it kind of comes to knowing what to leave in your camper, and every situation is different, especially if you store your camper at a place that somebody might break into it and steal stuff. You would might want to not make sure you put certain things in there. But for the most part, all food comes out and everything else can stay. That's all your call. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, you probably would like my Dollar Tree organization. Please subscribe. Until next time, like and subscribe.